What's up, everyone? This is Ed Talenti. How are you guys doing? You may be asking yourself, dude, where the hell are you? Well, this is my apartment. So basically, Italy changed its like quarantine laws for the coronavirus once again. And for the next couple of weeks, I'm not even allowed to take the 5-10 minute drive or whatever that I had from here to my actual studio. So on Sunday, I was like, what do? I just brought all my stuff here. And for the next couple of weeks, we're gonna be making videos in here. The content is gonna be the same, beat making videos, tutorials. I'm actually planning to go live, so make sure to follow me on Instagram because I'm gonna announce it like either today or tomorrow. And I'm planning to do like a live beat critique. Anyway, it's gonna be the same stuff, just in a different spot. So I apologize in advance if it's a little bit dark, if the shot looks kind of weird. I'm still working on it. I'm gonna try to make it, you know, the best I can, but it's all good. It's just a couple of weeks. The flu gang never stops. Let's get into the video. All right, today we're talking about one of the most requested topics on this channel of like all time, and it's how to find the key of a sample. Any sample, whether you're working with a melody, whether you're building a brand new melody, you're working with a sample, you downloaded and you wanna chop it up, this has so many different uses and it's just super important to know which key you're working in when you're building a beat. I'm gonna show you guys two different methods to do this. They're both really easy and really quick. The first one is even easier and quicker, like you literally have to do nothing, but it's got some problems that I'm gonna show you in a second. The second one takes a little bit of practice, but I'm gonna show you guys how to do it and it's gonna be worth the time. All right, let's get into the first method, which is finding the key by using a piece of software. It's free, called Keyfinder. This works on both Windows and Mac, and I'm gonna put links in the description. There are a lot of different programs and plugins that kind of do the same function, but I like Keyfinder. I'm gonna talk about that one because it's multi-platform, because you can just download it on any computer, and also because it runs batch analysis. What that means is that you can basically import any amount of samples. It can be like 100 samples. It's gonna scan them all at once. It's gonna give you back the keys and you're good to go. All right, so here's how it works. I'm gonna show it to you by using these melodies from a free sample pack that my good friends over at Loop Legends sent me. In the pack, there are like 11 melodies, a bunch of drums, some Electrax presets. There's a lot of stuff. It's completely free. I'll link in the description. Make sure to check it out. All right, so literally, I'm gonna take my melodies right here. I'm gonna drag them into Keyfinder. I'm gonna go down here and press Run Batch Analysis. Wait a second, and boom, I got all my keys for every single one of the melodies. It doesn't get any faster than that. It literally takes 2 seconds. So obviously this method works fine, but I have a couple of problems with it. The first one being that sometimes it gets the wrong key, especially if the chord progression of the sample is a little more complex. It just gives you like the fifth or the third. It just kind of messes up a little bit. The second problem I have with it is that it doesn't teach you anything. Like you have your key, you have your final result, but you have no idea how you got there. It's kind of like if you had like a really complex like math equation and it told you like, hey, it equals 3. And now you know it equals 3, but you don't know why, you don't know how you got there. And that's never a great thing because you're relying on a piece of software, and it's just better to know how to do things yourself, like to actually know how to do it. And that's exactly why we're gonna talk about method number 2. This is the method that I personally use the most on a daily basis. It doesn't require any music theory at all, just a little bit of ear training, which honestly, out of all the skills that there are out there for a music producer, musician, anything that has to do with music, ear training is probably the most important one. So here's how it works. I picked one of the melodies from that sample pack that I was just talking about. This one is called Ed Joins the Mob. I had to pick this one. I pulled up a piano here on my MPK Mini. So we're gonna start listening to the melody, and while it's looping, we're gonna press some notes, and we need to find a note that works with the entire loop from beginning to end. A little tip for you, it's a lot easier to hear which notes are working with the melody if you stay in like the higher octave. So we're gonna stay up here and we're gonna find our key. There it is, the key of the sample, it's A. Of course, if you know music theory pretty well, there are way better ways to go about this. You can like analyze the chord progression, figure out the tonal center, the key center, and then figure out the key from there. But if you don't know music theory, if you just know it a little bit, this is a really simple, quick method to find your key for whatever you're working on without having to really know anything. You just have to like train your ears. In fact, it's so quick, let's just do another one. I'm gonna pick a melody from my own sample pack, RIP Speakers Volume 2, my newest sample pack. The melody is called Moonlight. I'm just gonna go ahead and drag it into Ableton. Now, obviously I already know that this is an E flat. It's even written in the title of the sample. It's my own melody, but I'm just gonna show you how it works one more time, just so you can see it. I'm gonna press play. Start clicking some notes. A really quick exercise that you can do is just pick any song that you want on Spotify, look for the key, give yourself like 30 seconds to find the key on a piano, then go and look up the key of the song and make sure that you got it right. All right, super quick but really important video today. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to subscribe button and notification bell. I really appreciate that. I'm in the dark. Did the light just die like right now, or has it been dead for a while? I don't know. It doesn't matter. All right, I guess this is it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching the video all the way through. I'll see you next time, and as always, be positive, and positive things will happen.